And welcome to our Tenebrae prayer service for Holy Wednesday. You're going to experience an interesting and very ancient service this evening. And one of the things I want you to know is that as we lose the light that is here, we'll end the service with just the cantors chanting in the darkness. And so you just sit and reflect while that's happening toward the end. As the candles are extinguished and things become darker, you'll notice that there's one candle that will remain, and that is known as the Christ candle. At the time when that candle is removed and we're in darkness together, that represents what our lives are like and what the world is like without Christ in it, or without God's sense of presence in it. And during that time is when we're kind of reflecting on Christ in the tomb. And when that is restored, we hear a sound that's meant to be startling. It is meant to create a sense of unexpected fear and shock and surprise, to remind us that many times God in our life acts in that way. And what that is the break open of the tomb. When the light has been restored that symbolizes the light of Christ, you're invited to stay here. You'll see that the cantors and the Eucharistic ministers will leave. Once we've departed, you're welcome to stay here as long as you'd like to in meditation. Otherwise, we ask that you depart in silence, please. If you need help seeing our way out, an usher is there with a flashlight. And now let's take a moment to gather the prayers of our hearts as we enter into this holy and ancient life.
A reading from the Lamentations of Jeremiah the prophet. Aleph. How solitary lies the city, once so full of people. How widowed has she become, she that was great among the nations. She that was queen among the cities has now become a vassal. Beth. She weeps bitterly in the night. Tears run down her cheeks. Among all her lovers, she has none to comfort her. All become her enemies. Gimel. Judah has gone into the misery of exile and of hard servitude. She dwells now among the nations, but finds no resting place. All her pursuers overtook her in the midst of her anguish. Ella. The roads to Zion mourn, because none come to the solemn feasts. All her gates are desolate. Her priests groan and sigh. Her virgins are afflicted, and she is in bitterness. Hey. Her adversaries have become her masters. Her enemies prosper, because the Lord has punished her for the multitude of her rebellions. Her children are gone, driven away as captives by the enemy.
Return to the Lord your God.
sorrow,
even to the point of death.
We may hear what thou art to me. Now you shall see the crowd who is around me. You will flee, and I will go to be offered up for you.
Behold, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of those who will turn away from God's gifts of true life, love, and freedom.
You will flee, and I will go to offer myself to you, God's saviors.
Yod. The adversary has stretched out his hand to seize all her precious things. She has seen the Gentiles invade her sanctuary, those whom you had forbidden to enter your congregation. Kaf. All her people groan as they search for bread. They sell their own children for food to revive their strength. Behold, O Lord, and consider, for I am now beneath contempt. Lament. Is it nothing to you, all you who pass by? Behold and see if there is any sorrow like my sorrow, which has brought upon me, which the Lord inflicted on the day of his burning anger. Men. From on high he sent fire, into my bones it descended. He spread a net for my feet and turned me back. He has left me desolate and faint all the day long. None. My transgressions were bound into a yoke. By his hand they were fastened together. Their yoke is upon my neck. He has caused my strength to fail. The Lord has delivered me into their hands, against whom I am not able to stand up.
Jerusalem, Jerusalem, return to the Lord your God.
See with the vision of the heart. We have seen him without beauty or majesty.
He was appalling in the eyes of those who do not see above. He bore our fears and wrongs, and yet he grieved for us. He was wounded by human transgressions, and yet by scourging and death, we are offered healing.
Surely, he has borne our own troubles and cares.
They shall mourn for him as one mourns for an only child, for the one who is without sin is slain. Faithfulness be my supplication.
Christ for us became obedient unto death, even death on the cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him, and bestowed on him the name which is above every name. Let us now observe a holy silence.
People